Video, we studied about measurement of angles, how to convert radians into degrees, etc., etc. Now, in this video, I am taking up trigonometric ratios. Let us see what these trigonometric ratios are. See, here, let us say I have a vector starting from here. I will make it to trace an angle in the positive direction. Let me call this by some name. I'll call that as OP. So it has traveled from here. Always this is the reference line, this is the zero line. From here it has traveled this much angle, it has covered this much angle. We will call that as theta, that angle as theta. Now OP is this vector which has covered an angle of theta in positive direction. And now what I do here is, I will drop from P, I will drop a perpendicular onto the x-axis. This is my x-axis. Here I will drop a perpendicular to this. That is, this angle is 90 degree. Now I will call this as, this point as M. So OPM is a right angle triangle. I am getting a right angle triangle OPM. This triangle has three sides. What are the three sides? The three sides are OP or PO. You can call it as OP or PO. Now this is the longest side here in this triangle, because this is the biggest angle here. The angle opposite to that angle is called as the biggest, that will be the biggest side, and this is called as the hypotenuse of the triangle. This is called hypotenuse of the triangle. Now the next side is PM or MP. PM or MP. Now this side is the side opposite to angle theta. So it is called opposite side. With respect to theta, it is called the opposite side. And OM or MO, this is called as the adjacent side. This is adjacent to angle theta. So these are the three sides. Now these three sides, a right angle triangle or any triangle has only three sides. Here I have taken a right angle triangle and this has got three sides. With these three sides, how many ratios can be made? Say I have three numbers A, B and C. Now with these three numbers, to make a ratio, you know, you require two numbers. One is the numerator and the other is the denominator. So what you can do is A by B, B by C, C by A, then B by A, the reciprocal of this, B by A, the reciprocal of this, that is C by B, the reciprocal of this, that is A by C. You can make six ratios and not more than those six ratios. We cannot make more than six ratios. Similarly, with these three sides of the triangle, three sides means this length, the length of this side, length of this side and length of this side, they will be different lengths. Now with those three lengths, I can make only and only six ratios. Now these six ratios which I can make is, the first one is PM by OP, that is opposite by hypotenuse. This is the first one, first ratio that I can make. Then the next ratio is OM by OP, that is adjacent by hypotenuse. The third one is PM by OM, that is opposite by adjacent. The fourth one is the reciprocal of this, that is OP by PM, that is hypotenuse by opposite. The fifth one is the reciprocal of this, OP by OM, that is hypotenuse by adjacent, hypotenuse by adjacent. And the sixth one is OM by PM, OM by PM, that is adjacent by opposite. These are the six ratios. Now these six ratios are known as the trigonometric ratios of this particular angle theta. Now one quality of these ratios will be, as long as this angle doesn't change, irrespective of the lengths of these sides, these ratios will be constant. That is, what happens is, if I increase this OP, if I take it here, now what will happen is, this M will move to M dash. OM and PM also have increased proportionately, and these values will remain same. Say, for example, if I take, say theta is 30 degree. When theta is 30 degree, now if you measure this length, PM, if you measure, and if you measure OP, you will find that this side is exactly half of this, or this side is, the hypotenuse is exactly double of the opposite side. Hypotenuse will be double the opposite side. So they maintain a constant ratio, and these ratios are known as the trigonometric ratios of angle theta, and this is defined as sine of theta. Sine of theta. This is defined as cosine of theta. This is defined as tangent of theta. This is defined as cosecant of theta. This is defined as secant of theta. And this is defined as cotangent of theta. Cotangent of theta. These six ratios, they are shortly written as sin theta, S-I-N. This is written as cos theta. This is written as tan theta. This is written as cosec theta. This is written as sec theta. This is written as cot of theta, cot theta. So these are the six ratios. There are only six ratios, because you cannot make a seventh ratio, because you have in a triangle only three sides, and with those three sides of a right angle triangle, we can only make these six ratios. These six ratios are called as the trigonometric ratios of that particular angle. Then these ratios are interrelated. There is relationship between these things. Now some of them are very relevant to you. You know from here, you know that this and this are reciprocal to each other. That is, you can write 7, I can write cosec theta can be written as 1 by sin theta, or sin theta can be written as 1 by cosec theta, I can write like that. Then these two are reciprocal to each other, these two, 2 and 5, that is secant theta is 1 by cos theta, or cos theta is 1 by secant theta. Then ninth one, I can write this and this are reciprocal to each other. That is tan theta is cot theta is 1 by tan theta. Cot theta is 1 by tan theta, or tan theta is 1 by cot theta. Anyway, we can write it. They are reciprocal to each other. One is the reciprocal of the other. Then tenth one will be, see, if I divide sin theta by cos theta, sin theta divided by cos theta, what do I get? I get sin theta is PM by OP, and cos theta is OM by OP. So this OP, this OP gets cancelled. So I get P PM by OM, that is opposite by adjacent in our triangle. PM is opposite, OM is adjacent, so this will be equal to tan theta. So this is a relationship. I can write, whenever I get tan theta, I can write it as sin theta by cos theta. Sin theta by cos theta. The 11th relationship is, what happens if I divide cos theta by sin theta? Cos theta by sin theta, similarly, if you divide, will give me cot theta. So cot theta can be written as cos theta by sin theta. So these are interrelationships. Then there are some more interrelationships. We will take up that. We have done 11. Now I will move to 12th one. 12th relationship. I think you have understood this. I am going to move to the 12th relationship. Now, I'll come to 12th relationship. Here, you know our triangle is OPM is our right angle triangle. This is O, this is P, this is M, this is right angle here. This angle is theta. We started with that. Now, in triangle OPM, by Pythagoras theorem, I'll apply the Pythagoras theorem here. We know that, what do we know? The Pythagoras theorem says, in any right angle triangle, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares on the other two sides. This is the statement of Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem states, in any right angle triangle, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares on the other two sides. Now, this can be written mathematically in the form of an equation. The equation will be PM square plus OM square will be equal to OP square. Square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares on the other two sides. This is the statement of Pythagoras theorem in sentence. It can be mathematically written like this. Now I will call this as equation 1. Now first what I will do is A dividing equation 1. This equation, dividing equation 1 throughout by OP square, we get PM square by OP square. I am dividing this equation throughout by OP square plus OM square by OP square. This is also divided by OP square, is equal to OP square by OP square. Right? I have divided this equation throughout by OP square. Now, PM means opposite side, OP means hypotenuse. So, PM by OP is sine theta. So, PM square by OP square will be equal to sine square theta. This can be written as sin square theta plus OM in the triangle is adjacent side, adjacent by hypotenuse, OP is hypotenuse, this is cos theta. OM square by OP square can be written as cos square theta is equal to OP square by OP square, both numerator and denominator are same, so this will be 1, they get cancelled, so you get 1. So I got a relationship like this. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, or sin square theta is equal to, if I send it that side, it will be 1 minus cos square theta, or it can be written this way also, cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. So whenever we want, in depending upon the problem in which we are doing, we can use these relationships in whichever way we want. We can write sin square, we can use this relationship, this relationship, this relationship, as and how we get to do the problems, you will understand that these relationships can be used. Now, next, what I do, I'll rub this. Now, this is common, this part is common. Now, I will call this as B. First, I have divided this equation throughout by OP square. Now, what I do is, I will divide it by OM square. If I divide it by OM square throughout, what do I get? PM square by OM square plus OM square by OM square is equal to OP square by OM square. I have divided all the three by the same quantity, that is OM square, OM square, OM square. Now PM is opposite, OM is adjacent. Opposite by adjacent by definition is tan theta. So tan square theta plus this becomes 1 is equal to OP is hypotenuse divided by OM adjacent. Hypotenuse by adjacent is secant theta. So it will become secant square theta. So tan square theta plus 1 is equal to secant square theta. Again, this can be written as tan square theta is equal to secant square theta minus 1. This 1 can be sent that side, then tan square theta. Wherever you get secant square theta minus 1, you can write it as tan square theta. Or whenever you want, if you have tan square theta, you can write it as secant square theta. Or secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. This way also it can be used. Any way we want, we can use these three relationships. They are one and the same. I have just transferred this from one side to the other side. So this is another relationship that you get. Then the third relationship that you get is again from this same PM square by. Now what I will do is, I will divide this C, 12C. I will divide, dividing equation 1 through by, what is left? PM square. We have divided by, first we divided by OP square, then I divided by OM square, now I will divide it by PM square. PM square by PM square plus OM square by PM square is equal to OP square divided by PM square. I have divided now all the three terms here by PM square. So PM square by PM square means I get 1 plus OM by PM adjacent by opposite is cot theta. So it is cot square theta, 1 plus cot square theta is equal to OP by PM is secant square theta. Cosecant square theta. Cosecant square theta. Now, it can be written as this way. Cot square theta is equal to cosecant square theta minus 1. Or, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. Whenever we want, we can do it like this. Now, if you know this much relationships, these interrelationships between different trigonometric ratios, you can definitely get 5 marks. How? They will give, always a problem will be given, wherein they will ask you to prove a trigonometric identity. Trigonometric identity you will be asked to prove. at least 5 marks will be there. Those of you who are writing the 9 scheme paper, for them at least a minimum of 9 marks will be there. Now how? I'll tell you. Here I take a few problems. Now this is a question paper 9SC01M, April May 2018, section C. This is 9SC01M, problem number 25. He says prove that, this is the problem, prove that 1 by 1 plus cos theta plus 1 by 1 minus cos theta is equal to 2 cosecant square theta. This problem is called as a trigonometric identity. Here they will ask us to prove something is equal to something. Here the first basic concept you understand. See, first what we do, we take the left hand side. The left hand side here is 1 by 1 plus cos theta plus 1 by 1 minus cos theta. This is the left hand side. Now we must go on simplifying this till we get that answer. Till we get the right hand side. Take the left hand side. Here, see, when you take the first step, this is the first step, then there are 6 ratios, sine, cos, tan, cosecant, secant and cot. These are the 6 ratios, trigonometric ratios. Now what we have to do is, in the left hand side, first primary thing what we have to do is, if there are these two, leave them like that, these two. If you have tan, then this tan can be written as sin theta by cos theta. Convert it into sin theta by cos theta. If you have anywhere here cosecant, 1 by sin, you convert it as 1 by sin. If you have secant, convert it as 1 by cos. If you have cot, you convert it as cos theta by sin theta. This is the first step you have to do. Now in this particular problem, this does not arise because it doesn't have tan, cosecant, secant, cot. These are not there in the left hand side. So only cos theta is there. So it doesn't, this doesn't apply here. I am talking generally, if you have a problem like that, where you have any one of these ratios, you will have to convert it. So that is it. Now you see here, how to go about it. See, this is a fraction and this is also a fraction. There is a positive sign. So it is addition of two fractions. Whenever two fractions are to be added or subtracted, what we have to do is, we have to take the LCM of the denominators. So here same procedure is to be followed. So the LCM is 1 plus cos theta multiplied by 1 minus cos theta. They are conjugate. This is A plus B, that is A minus B. Now here what you get? You get 1 into 1 minus cos theta, because this will get cancelled here. 1 into 1 minus cos theta. Here you have plus. If it is plus, you write plus. If it is minus, you write minus. So again here 1 into 1 plus cos theta. That is, this will come there and this will come here. Now, 1 into 1 is 1 only, minus cos theta, plus 1 into 1 is 1 only, plus into plus cos theta. Here, a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. That is 1 square minus cos square theta. A plus b into a minus b. This is a plus b. This is a minus b. If you multiply these two, the product is a square minus b square. So 1 square. A square is 1 square. B square is cos square theta. Here, this minus cos theta plus cos theta, they get cancelled. So what is left here is 1 plus 1 is 2 divided by 1 minus cos square theta. Now, we know 12a, if you go to 12a, 1 minus cos square theta can be written as sin square theta. 1 minus cos square theta is sin square theta. So 2 by sin square theta. Now, this can be written as 2 into cosecant square theta. If you take sin square theta to the top, to the numerator, from denominator to numerator, it becomes cosecant square theta because they are reciprocal to each other. So, this is the RHS. So, we have proved that this is equal to that. This will fetch 5 marks. Okay. We'll do one more problem. Now I'll take up 9SC01M. November, December 2017. Section C. Again, problem number 25 for 5 marks. Let's do one more problem. This is, I have taken from paper November, December 2017. Section C. Problem number 25 for again 5 marks. The problem is like this. Prove that root of 1 minus cos A divided by 1 plus cos A is equal to cosecant A minus cot A. So we have to prove that this is equal to that. This again carries 5 marks. Now, here again I take the left hand side. The left hand side is root of 1 minus cos A divided by 1 plus cos A. Now, what I do is, I have in the denominator, I have A plus B. So, the conjugate of this is A minus B. So, I have to multiply it by 1 minus cos A. If I have to multiply it by 1 minus cos A, here also I must multiply it by 1 minus cos A. So, now what happens here is, this becomes 1 minus cos A the whole square. That is, A minus B into A minus B is A minus B the whole square. In the denominator, A plus B into A minus B becomes A square minus B square. That is, 1 minus cos square A. Now, that will be equal to, if you thing, 1 minus cos A the whole square divided by 1 minus cos square A is sin square A. Now, if I take out the root, the square root of 1 minus cos A, the whole square is 1 minus cos A, and the square root of sin square A is sin A. Now, what I will do, this will be split into two. This can be written as 1 by sin A minus cos A by sin A. So, 1 by sin A is cosecant A. Reciprocal of sin is cosecant. Cos A by sin A is cot A. Cot A. So, cosecant A minus cot A, I got the right hand side. So, this answer is got. I have proved that this is equal to this. That will fetch you 5 marks.